jingle bells swing and
jingle bells ring. Was the week before break, and all through the school, not a student was listening or following the rules. The teachers were tired and worse for the wear, in hopes that vacation soon would be there. The days crept on slowly, but soon it was near. Finally, yes, December 22nd was here. Teachers and students cheered and they clapped and settled their brains for a long winter's nap. As the clock struck two and the math teachers left, they thought to themselves they deserved a good rest. When suddenly a thought crossed all of their minds, did I make enough copies and post lessons on time? As the English teachers went to make their way home, they began to feel very sad and alone. They soon realized why they felt so gray. What would they do without a remote teaching day? Nothing could stop our great science team from running through the doors, heads full of steam. They celebrated too early, they came to realize their car keys were missing. How unwise. The social studies teachers began gathering their things and thinking what joy the holidays bring. As they began to walk out the door, they all slipped and fell on the floor. When the foreign language teachers decided to leave, they did not know the bad news they'd received. Their planning for January was not good anymore. Most students were now remote and hybrid no more. The art teachers thought they were in for a treat. Winter vacation would be very neat. That was until they tried to stand up and walk and realized we're much more tired than we thought. All the school nurses deserved a good treat, took a short break to have something to eat. With their bellies so full, they laid down their heads while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. As Mr. Stevens was tidying up books, one caught his eye, so he took a quick look. He said to himself, "I'll just read one page more," until he fell asleep with his book on the floor. The aides and assistants were ready to head out, eager to leave school without any doubts. "Something is wrong," they all yelled aloud. "We can't leave until Miss Snyder is found."
There'll be scary ghost stories and tales of the glories of Christmases long, long ago. It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be much mistletoeing and hearts.
All the teachers of health, music, and phys ed felt they had lost their minds and their heads. They were so exhausted, they decided to stay and agreed to drive home the very next day. The psychologist and school counseling department were focused on opening a tiny compartment. They thought there were presents locked deep inside and spent the whole night trying to open it wide. The secretaries were ready to walk out the door when the phone started ringing like never before. So they slumped back into their comfy black chairs and got ready to have a busy night. How unfair. And down in the office, there arose such a clatter, Miss Angelus and Mr. Hicks couldn't stop their chatter. They talked and they gabbed until way past bedtime. They didn't even notice the midnight bell chime. At last, the time came. They could work no more. They closed down their meets and left out the front door. They shouted together as they drove out of sight.
Not
happy holidays to all.
You know you're the mastermind.